Right, gentlemen, the last topic is in gyro is gyro errors. And thank you, Lakshmish Naik, for this nice drawing which you have done. I will use this to explain. You can sit down now. Okay, now when we talk of gyro errors, basically there are two errors. One is due to the speed of the vessel, and the other is due to the latitude. Right? Now, when we say speed, basically how does the gyro know which is north? So what the gyro does is it basically senses the rotation of the earth, which we said is from west to east. So it senses how the earth is rotating, and it knows that from west going to east, that's the east, 90 degrees to that is north, and that's where the gyro settles. So let's say OE, this is the main direction of rotation of the earth. So let's say this is the direction of rotation of the earth here. Right? Senses this and then settles 90 degrees to this, which is the north. Now imagine a ship which is moving in this direction OR. Right? Ship is moving in this direction. Okay, before we go to that, let's say the ship is moving along OE. Now, what is the rotational speed of the earth? 15 degrees per hour, isn't it? 24 hours and 360 degrees. So, 15 degrees per hour. So, 15 degrees is 15 into 60. So, 900 miles per hour. Rotational speed of the earth. But, remember that on the equator, it is that much. As we said here, if you can see on this, the equator here is moving like this. If you look at the angular distance covered by the equator is much larger than angular distance covered by higher latitudes. Right? On both sides. The angular distance. So, in terms of degrees, it may be the same. But in terms of angular, in terms of the actual distance, it will be more at the equator, less on top. So, when I say 90, I would not like to say 900 miles, but I would rather say 15 degrees per minute. But we need to remember the miles because the ship is in nautical miles, knots, which is nautical miles per hour. So if even on the equator, if this is 900 miles per hour and ship speed is 20 knots, 25 knots, it only becomes 925. That's about it. So in the east-west direction, or if the ship is moving, say 270, in the east-west direction, if it is moving, it only increases or rather adds or gets subtracted from the figure of rotation of the earth. Right? So it doesn't make much of a difference. It will always settle north. So in the east-west direction, the gyro error is minimum, rather almost zero. Right? It only adds to the speed or subtracts from the earth speed. When you are in the north coast, imagine a ship moving northerly, ship moving in this direction, northerly. It will have maximum effect because if the ship, let's say if this distance OV, as it says here, ships travel in unit time. So if I take 1 hour, this is the ship traveled in 1 hour. OE is the earth's rotation in the same unit time, so OE is also in 1 hour. So if I look at this OV and OE, my resultant is OR. So in the northerly, when the ship is moving in the northerly direction, 000, I will get this, and the ship's equipment or the gyroscope will think this as the north. So it will actually settle down here in the direction of N dash, not at N. This is a virtual meridian, of course. True meridian is there. So this angle here will become the error. Right? Call it theta, whatever you like, that's the error. Now this, as you can see, is maximum on northerly courses, as we said, zero on east-west. If the course is southerly, that means the course is in this direction, you can have an image of this here. So this would come down, again same unit time, etc. And you would have a resultant like this. This would give us the gyro settling somewhere here. Let's call it N2 dias. Right? Which means on a northerly course, the error is westerly. On a southerly course, the error is
easterly.
Clear? Northerly course, error is westerly. Southerly course, error is
easterly.
Because this component now would go down. You are on a course 180. So this component is here. Is this part clear? Now, on any other course, that means if your course, for example, is 045 or 030 or 060, whatever it may be, it will have, any course will have two components, isn't it? When you say course is 060, you will still have two components to this course. One will be the northerly component, one will be the easterly component. Easterly component would not affect because that just increases or decreases the speed. The northerly component will reduce or increase, so OV will vary. Depending on the variation in OV, for example, if you are on a course of 060, right, then when you resolve this, you will get, let's look at it like this. If this course is 60 degrees, then this factor will become whatever. Let's say you are doing 15 knots, so this will be 15 cos 60 because angle is this side. If I take it from here, then this becomes the cos factor. Now, I am not interested in this because this is only going to increase or decrease the rotational speed of the earth. So, this factor, which earlier we took here V because as the unit, now instead of northerly course on any other course, you will have a northerly component. So, that will change, resultant will change, the angle of error will change. So, whenever you are on northerly courses, that means on any course 270. To 090, going this way, 270, 280 and all up to 090, this will have a northerly component. You can say 270 and 090 don't have any north or south component, so technically you could say 271 to 089. They will have an error which will be westerly. If you are on courses from the other way around, that means from say 091 up to 269. Right, I just change this to 071 and this to 089. Now don't tell me 0.9 and 0.8, I'm just not going to points, okay? Alright, so on this courses, southerly courses, the error will be easterly. Northerly courses, the error will be
westerly.
Now, in the olden days, there was a latitude and speed correction which we had to feed. Because you understand the rotational speed of the earth, as I said, in terms of actual distance depends on the latitude, right?
Yes,
whereas in the olden days, as I was saying, we used to have a speed input, latitude input into the gyro. Nowadays the latitude and speed inputs can come from the GPS, the gyro could be interfaced to GPS. So you may not actually be feeding it, but this error is there, which gets corrected by automatic, by the feed. So when your GPS is giving the speed input, course input, then and the latitude input of course, then all this calculation can be done within the system and the error will be applied and actually you will not have any error. So these corrections are done within the system in today's day. And as I said earlier, we had latitude speed setting, nowadays we don't have it, it is done automatically. So is this part clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
The other thing of course is, as we said, latitude error, that is same, actually it is already covered in the speed. When I said latitude, we are talking of, again that the angular speed could be more or less, and on that basis you would have some error. But that also in today's day is corrected directly, so there is no... Because latitude input is given to the gyro through the GPS, so there is no issue of latitude error or speed error practically. But you need to know that these are the two errors. One is called as speed, some people call it as course and speed error. Yes, the course is important because that's how we determine how much is the northerly or southerly component. But having said that, irrespective of the course, if your speed is zero, then there is no error. Right, then it's only heading. You may be heading 045, 030, 270 or 210, whatever you may be heading. If the speed is 0, that means this component is 0. Heading has got no meaning. Post really comes into picture only when there is speed. Right, so you could also call it as post and speed error or only speed error. Up to you. Right, and latitude error, as I told you, yes, it is there depending on which latitude you are. Right, now normal gyros which you use on ships are not used beyond 60 degrees north latitude, basically because of this latitude error, the rotational speed factor, the distance covered. We need some amount there, which of course the other factor also is in colder places, freezing and all that can occur, so a lot of other issues will be there. So not going into too much of detail there, just remember that the marine gyros which are normally used on ships can be used up to 60 in, depending on the construction of the gyros, some can be used up to 70 and 75 degrees latitude also. Generally for very high latitudes, there is a different gyro which is called as a laser gyro, those are used. Again, beyond the scope of this class, so I won't go into laser gyros and other things. But just remember that yes, we have something known as laser principle and laser gyros for very high latitudes. Up to 60, normal gyro, 60, 70, 75, special construction gyros can be used. So is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any questions, any doubts on this?
No.
Okay, just to tell you all, I mean, I'm sure you've already seen this. But this is the book on navigates, which I'm sure you're using it already.
Yes, sir.
And this has got a chapter on gyro. And the figures which I was showing you, I'll just show them to you one by one. Very quickly, I'm not here to put it on the video completely. But this chapter on gyro has got all these figures which I was telling you. So you need to refer to these figures along with this video when you are studying the chapter on gyro. Okay, this here explains you the precision part is given, explained to you in these two figures, 1 and 2 here, precision part. This of course rotation of the earth as I showed you is given on this. There are a few figures here to show you the effect of top heavy, bottom heavy, etc. And then these are depending on whether using north latitude, south latitude or equator, how would the single damping work. This is making it north seeking, and what you are seeing here on the board, this drawing which Naik drew out, is also from this book. It is here. Right, if you, after reading this, if you have any questions or any doubts, you can always contact me. But this is one book which I have written, and this contains almost everything that you need to know for your examinations. And practically out at sea also people are using it. It is also useful for phase 2. Right? Any more questions on this?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you very much then.
Thank you, sir.
All the best.